What is the Perseid meteor shower? The Perseid meteor shower peaks on the night of August 11th and the wee hours of August 12th, but you can start looking for meteors now. Meteors are often called shooting stars, but they're not really stars at all. The streaks of light you see in the sky are small particles of rock or ice that burn up as they fall through the Earth's atmosphere. Most are the size of a grain of sand, but some larger ones make it to the ground as meteorites. When they're still in space, meteors are called meteoroids. They are pieces of debris removed from the surfaces of comets and asteroids. This debris continues in orbit around the sun as meteoroid streams. A meteor shower occurs when the Earth moves through one of these streams. As the Earth plows through the debris, the atmosphere acts like the windshield of a car driving through a snowstorm, and the meteors can be seen to streak across the sky. The Perseid meteoroid stream comes from Comet Swift-Tuttle, which last passed the Earth's orbit at the end of 1992, and due to the 133 years it takes the comet to orbit the Sun, it won't pass the Earth's orbit again until the year 2126. The Earth moves through this stream in the same part of its orbit each year, so the Perseids are always active in our sky during the second half of July and most of August. This year we will reach the middle of Comet Swift-Tuttle's meteoroid stream in the wee hours of August 12th, the peak of the Perseid meteor shower. Meteor showers are named for the point in the sky where the meteors appear to originate, a location called the radiant. The location of the radiant depends on the combined motion of the Earth and the meteoroids themselves. The radiant of the Perseids is in the constellation Perseus. Let's go to the Giovalli Open Deck Observatory, here at Lowell Observatory, to see how this looks from the ground. All you need to see meteors are your own two eyes and a dark sky. You'll want to be on that windshield side of the Earth as it plows through the meteoroid stream, but you also want the radiant to be as high as possible while the sky is still dark. Usually, this means 3 or 4 in the morning, but this year, a last quarter moon will rise around midnight local time. So the best viewing this year will conveniently be during the dark hours after sunset and before midnight in your local time zone. During the Perseid meteor shower, the meteoroids from Comet Swift-Tuttle approach Earth from high above the plane of our solar system. So the Perseids are best seen from the northern hemisphere, where up to 100 meteors per hour can be seen at the shower's peak. However, the number of meteors you see will depend on how dark your sky is. Perseid meteors are very fast and typically faint. About an hour after sunset, you'll find the radiant very low in the northern sky, below the W-shaped constellation Cassiopeia. While the radiant is this low, you won't see as many meteors, but the ones you do see will tend to travel far across the sky from north to south. Near midnight and before the moon rises, the radiant will be much higher in the sky, so you'll see more Perseids, but they'll have shorter paths across the sky. While you're watching for meteors in the northern sky, take a break to look at Jupiter and Saturn, which are still putting on quite a show in the southern sky, with Mars rising shortly before midnight. Join Lowell Observatory on Tuesday night, August 11th, for a live stream of the Perseid meteor shower. We'll use the all-sky camera at the Lowell Discovery Telescope to hunt for meteors together. After that, you'll be ready to find more on your own when the Perseid meteor shower peaks in the hours before midnight.